Prof, buenas tardes, mucho gusto, bienvenido a Quito. Como te contaron, mi blog está especializado en temas aeronáuticos. Es muy importante que la gente conozca qué es Yun, cómo va a ser la operación. Entonces, la primera pregunta sería, ¿cuándo empieza la aerolínea a volar a Ecuador?
When is the airlines starting their flights into Ecuador, into Quito?
The fourth in English, no.
Yes, if you want.
14th of May, we will start our seasonal operations with the June from Paris with an Airbus A340-300, as you have noticed, standing here. And it will be initially a seasonal flight with three flights a week. Remind me of the exact dates, the days.
Tuesdays son martes, jueves y sábado, 3 veces por semana a partir del 14 de mayo del 2019.
We are very proud of the introduction of June because it's on top of the very successful flights that KLM already operates. We hope that the seasonal will turn into a year-round operation after the proven success of the startup of this flight.
¿Qué necesita Quito para que el vuelo sea year-round?
What do we need to make it a
See, June offers three classes on board. So we are also looking at developing the corporate business from the Ecuadorian market because we offer business class and with, remind me, 30 seats and 21 seats in premium economy. No.
And 220.
220 in tourists. So we are looking both at tourist and corporate market to be developed from Quito to Paris. But the business case itself showed there is a high interest from European markets to come to Ecuador and beyond.
Okay. Volviendo, o sea, ahora más bien hablando del tema del avión como tal, ¿qué capacidad tiene el avión? Características generales del avión.
Sí, Juan es una aerolínea viva, innovadora, creativa y enfocada en el cliente, ¿no? Está en constante evolución, prueba nuevos productos, busca nuevas y mejores maneras de hacer las cosas para conectarse y servir mejor a sus clientes. It's a product that maintains the full service that Air France has, but allows us to experiment with another type of service on board, be it the entertainment system, which has a different connection. You download an app, and when you enter the plane, the Wi-Fi will work, and then you have a lot of online onboard displays of documentaries, music clips, all kinds of short, interesting documentaries that are of interest of the customers. Also, the informal act of the crew, which is dressed in sneakers, jeans, and t-shirts, allows for another atmosphere on board. It's smart casual to the extent that it is more casual than smart. It's very interesting to see how that develops. And I understood in the discussion in the start of this interview about the millennials, it's a bigger group of young people, young entrepreneurs that we try to address with this product, not forgetting the basics of Air France with regards to the booking classes, the quality of our services like food and security and on the ground services that we will maintain at the level of Air France.
¿Por qué no se usó la marca Air France, que es mucho más reconocida en el mercado?
Sí, that's a good question. June allows us to experiment on board with different concepts, but the brand of Air France does not allow us to do that.
Okay.
It's such a well-established brand for 85 years that people expect the French wine, the French cheese, the French fashion, and the French quality of service. June allows for more flexibility. I've been working for KLM since 1985, and KLM has always been a pioneer in developing other concepts, but we are able to do that in our own product. The strength of the brand of Air France is such that you cannot touch that with trying other things, which June gives us the opportunity to do so.
Okay. Otra pregunta muy interesante que a la gente le va, le intriga saber, ¿es Yun una low cost?
No. It's not a low cost. If it would have been a low cost, we would have a high density tourist class on the flight. Then we would have paid services for food and entertainment. Then everything else, ancillary services as we call it, would have been paid for during the check-in process. It's not saying that we will not do that on June, but it is aligned with Air France KLM. Because of the combinability of the airfares between Air France KLM and June, we cannot have complete different products. So it's not a low cost, it's completely aligned in the service deliverables as Air France and KLM as such.
And the three classes.
And the three booking classes that I already mentioned, with the full flat business class and the full services of the premium economy and economy class as such. So no payment for food, for instance, which is a clear indication that we aim for another product with another vibe and not so much another product at a lower cost as a low-cost carrier with business model mm-hmm. would entail.
¿Cuál será el costo del pasaje?
The prices.
The prices.
There is a price combinability with Air France KLM. That means that the prices will be equal. The type of traffic will determine what price we will charge. If the June flight develops itself more for tourists, then applicable fares will apply, of course. But in principle, the fare combinability shows that both the Air France and KLM current fares will be applicable mm-hmm. to June. But it's extra capacity on top of the successful KLM flights between Guayaquil, Quito and Amsterdam. So it gives us a commercial opportunity also to develop new markets and new traffic flows from Quito and from Europe to Ecuador.
Galápagos es el principal destino turístico de, mm-hmm. de Ecuador. ¿Va a haber alguna alianza para transportar pasajeros desde París hacia Galápagos?
I have to ask that to Marie-Noël.
Estamos trabajando para con las aerolíneas domésticas poder manejar pasajeros que estén en tránsito hacia Galápagos o Guayaquil o Cuenca o cualquier,
claro, cualquier otro destino.
Al momento no tenemos una alianza con específica con una aerolínea determinada. De hecho, trabajamos con todas las aerolíneas. Tenemos acuerdos especiales con Aerogal, con Avianca, con TAME, inclusive con LAN. Nuestros pasajeros tienen la libertad de escoger con qué aerolínea quieren transportarse entre Guayaquil y Quito, que sería el caso, ¿no es cierto?, para poder empatar con el vuelo de Quito, o inclusive los pasajeros que vienen de fuera. Para los boletos que se emiten afuera tenemos unos SPAs específicos ya establecidos con Avianca y con TAM. Pero no tenemos al momento en planes, por lo menos, se está mirando el tema de hacer códigos compartidos a destinos más allá de Quito. Okay. En este momento, ¿no? O sea, eso puede cambiar, pero en este momento nos manejaremos con SPAs.
Okay. ¿Cuáles son las expectativas de este vuelo? ¿Qué, cuántos pasajeros al año o en temporada se espera transportar? Mm-hmm. ¿Cuáles son las estimaciones de tráfico?
There is, as you know from the airline industry, there's a critical load factor to mm-hmm. meet to make a flight profitable. Mm-hmm. Our business plan shows that that critical load factor can be met. If you look at Air France KLM, they're pretty high, they're in their 80s. Initially, there will be a challenge, of course, to meet that. But already we see booking coming in from the European points of sale,
yes.
Very promising. The expectations are that we will meet the critical load factor initially. And again, with the aim to make it not a seasonal, but a year-round product, so that Air France, after 25 years, returns, be it in the form of June, but basically with a product that originates from Charles de Gaulle. Because the strength that we offer is not only the fact that we have a flight, but we also offer Charles de Gaulle and Amsterdam mm-hmm. in a kind of triangle combination with Quito, and any combination is possible. And in the network strength, we believe that this flight will be profitable within the first season.
Excelente. Ahora, volviendo, más bien, cambiando de aerolínea, hablemos un poco de KLM, si es que es apropiado. ¿Cómo está KLM en Ecuador? ¿Cómo está KLM en la región? Porque ha crecido bastante fuerte. Igual Air France ha vuelto a muchos países, igual KLM. ¿Cómo está la situación general del grupo Air France KLM en toda la región?
in the region, KLM and Air France are both very successful. If we start from the top, San Jose, we operated since 2 years a year-round operation of Air France and a seasonal of KLM, and it looks very promising. It's pure tourism, I'm aware of it, but small and medium enterprises have found the route as well. Panama just recently moved to daily Air France and daily KLM, very successful in a very strong partnership for transit passengers with Copa, and it's developing very well. Bogota, the fifth flight of KLM will arrive on the 5th of December with an aim to go daily next to the Air France daily flight, and both with a 787, which is a unique position in the world of Air France KLM network, that both airlines operate the 787-900 to the destination. Lima, stronghold of KLM for years, has now four flights of Air France as well, doing very well. And of course now Quito opening up with additional capacity. There is also the challenges we face in Venezuela, where there are still six flights of Air France with an Airbus 330 doing well as a kind of lifeline between Venezuela and Paris and beyond, to accommodate the highly needed traffic and goods between the two countries. So there is a real focus on this region to increase capacity, to improve connections over Amsterdam and Paris, and the results have proven it itself. The load factors are high, the profitability, which is marginal in the airline business, is positive enough to sustain the growth that we plan to have, and it's looking very promising. I think we will close this book year of 2018 successfully for all the stations, and we're looking forward to make Bogota daily on KLM as well, and to make Ecuador daily for Air France in the near future.
Rolf, eso es por mi lado. Muchas gracias por tu tiempo.
Yeah.
Y cualquier cosa, siempre estamos a las órdenes. Muchas gracias.
Gracias.